thousands of gallons of crude oil are oozing into the Louisiana
coastal. Make no mistake. We will do whatever's necessary.
Quite an impact. This is a crisis.
I'm just a commercial fisherman. My whole life is based on this.
Have we brought in the best and the brightest of all the minds that could deal with this?
When you have bad weather, an old boom do nothing. We go out when all the others come in.
We are Team Kosek from the Netherlands, Peter Soek. There are six guys who are here to clean up as much oil as we can.
We make sweeping arms. The working is perfect for big oil spills.
The products of our company were used in the oil spills like the Prestige and Erica, and also in the Gulf last year.
Most systems are based off the fact that you contain an oil spot. And we don't contain, we chase the oil.
We have a steel arm that's pulled to the water, that builds up a layer of oil, and then we pump it away. It is rigid, it doesn't flex, so what it encounters, it collects. That's unique in the market, and we think it's the best system there is.
The equipment we bring is heavy, and it's big. The arm weighs roughly 10,000 pounds, because it comes totally assembled. If the equipment takes 2 days to prepare, then the slick is gone. We arrive, connect the hoses, put it on board, open it up, and there we go.
We have been to Amstrad once before, beginning of the 80s. Our team member, Gert Kempers, who is our general manager, tested the very first sweeping arm over here. Gert is a wonderful man. He invented the rigid sweeping arm, and now he's here helping us with the test. The demands for this X-Prize were quite challenging. A lot of volume, almost no water, and our system was always based on taking also in a lot of water, which was deposed later. This time we couldn't do it, so we have to find other ways. And we did that by a slide with a sensor, which measures the thickness of the layer, and that minimizes the water intake.
Theoretically, we can pump it easily. Practice will show later if that is true or not.
First I seen no problem, but because of the movement on the waves, there were a lot of forces on the bridge.
Emergency stop. What happened?
We have a problem.
We calculated for the drag, but that calculation was made for open water, like you have normal. But you are here in a swimming pool, and the swimming pool has sides, and the water can't go around our tool. So that gives a lot of drag on the back.
We designed the system to work at 3 knots. With the waves, it seemed that the Olmsted Bridge encountered a lot of forces, which was more than they had anticipated. So we have to slow the whole system down. We're going to narrow the arms to encounter less drag. It means because we have narrowed the angle that we will pick up less than we expected, but still we think we can good score.
Yeah.
Functions. It's functioning.
Well, we had the final run. We thought when we narrowed the angle that the oil intake would be far less. It was less, but not as less as we expected.
How do you feel?
Fantastic. I'm happy. Yeah.
It's great to be in this contest. We learned a lot. It showed us that we can improve our products even after 30 years. One day here learns more than 1 year behind your desk. It's a wonderful thing, this X-Prize.